Done here. You want to film the next one?
Really? Yeah, okay.
Yeah, Jack says he has another bench for us to film. Chains and stuff attached to it. He says it's a real 10 out of 10. Not that I believe him. The only 10 out of 10 I've ever seen was a bench back at my Meemaw's house. I used to sit on that thing for days at a time just watching people go by. When I told my Meemaw about it, she said I dreamt the whole thing up. I've always wondered if I'll ever be able to go back there, see it again someday.
This job's dangerous. What if you end up getting a splinter?
It's the risks of a reviewer, Meg. I do what I have to do to keep this community sitting on only the best benches. It's a risk I have to take.
What if you get hurt?
That's the way of a bench reviewer. You never know when the next splinter's gonna come. You just gotta deal with it.
God damn it, run away with me, Ned. You could start a new life. With the farm in Tennessee.
This again.
Quiet life. Just you and me. We'd never have to worry about any of this stuff ever again. Any of the dislikes. Any of the ratios, anything.
Any of the drama. Megan, every woman, seriously, every woman I've ever met has tried to run away with me. No one can resist a bench critic reviewer. But you know I'm only attracted to benches.
God damn it, Ned. You're just too handsome. And smart and beautiful. And do you want me to stop?
I know. Let's get out of here.
That's where it all started going downhill for us.
Let's say that.
It's true, isn't it?
We're rounding a corner, okay? Everybody has their ups and downs.
Well, I hate that piece of shit.
Don't swear!
Now this is the bench I've been talking about, man. This is the one.
This is the 10 out of 10?
Yes. This is the 10 out of 10.
Oh, Jack. Oh, Jack. Well, I'll review it. I'll take a look, but I can go ahead and tell you. You got a little bit of work to do when it comes to being a bench critic. This year, I'll take a look at it, though. Hello, everybody. It's another episode of Epic Bench Critic Reviews. It's been a lot of... I can't talk today. It's been a little bit of time. It's been too long. I am really sorry to my bench community, to my bench heads, all the benchers out there. It's been too long, and it's not my fault. I've been trying really hard. Some of the people I've been working with have been really dragging their feet in terms of getting things filmed, getting things edited, getting things recorded. Oh, come on! I'm just giving you a hard time. But it's not my fault, is what I'm trying to say. No, it's not my fault. It's just some of the people I've been working with. But it's okay. You know, we're on the timeline that we're given. So sometimes it takes a little bit. You might notice a few things different about me. Just try to ignore it, okay? Just try to ignore it, okay? Anyway, we have a little bit of a bitch going on right here. Oh my gosh, I feel rusty. This is so weird. I feel
like that.
Very funny. Very
feel
funny.
Like that.
Don't step out of line. But I was told by one of my colleagues that this bitch is... I was told it was a 10 out of 10. So we drove all the way out here into this horrible weather. Horrible, horrible weather. It's freezing cold. I don't know if you can see. I don't know if you can hear. Wind is blowing. It's awful right now. We drove all the way out here just to look at this bench because I was told it was a 10 out of 10. Spoiler alert, I don't think it's a 10 out of 10. We're going to get to there as we get to the review, but I don't think it's a 10 out of 10. I think he was wrong about that. And I think it was a little bit of a waste of time to come out here, but it's okay. We still got a bit of a bench going on. I'm just gonna try to get this one. I was expecting a 10 out of 10. I shouldn't get my hopes up when I'm dealing with people, but anyway. I don't like there to be craziness and gimmicks and just weird stuff going on because I think it just detracts from the experience. So what we have here is a bench that's on chains or some kind of, you know, chain sort of material. And the purpose of it, as you can see, is so once you do sit down on it, we're going to get to that. Once you do sit down on it, you can swing sort of. It's almost like a bench swing hybrid. I never was on the swing sets as a kid. I never did that stuff. Dangerous, you know, is what I'd always say. It was dangerous. One time I tried it, I got myself hurt. So I never bothered with that crap again. But I was on the benches, you know, like why would I need a swing? I'm on the bench. So today I'm gonna be trying to push my boundaries a little bit, break my mold, you know, get out of my comfort zone. Out here, this is not a fun filming experience for me. Thanks a lot, Jack. But I really don't want to be out here, but I am gonna push my boundaries just because I care about you guys, I care about the show, I care about all that stuff. So camera to get messed up. So
say what?
I don't want the camera. Are you doing a gag right now? I do the gags on this show. All right, we got a couple things to talk about. First of all, the bench itself is built into this big kind of like semi-circular chassis almost. And obviously the purpose for that is to support the chains. It's kind of
it's kind of a, it's like I said, it's a gimmick. It's not serving the bench. Because you see it from afar and you're like, oh, is this like a weird gazebo structure? No, it's a bench. You know, and it's not recognizable from a distance. So that's the first thing that's taken points off, Jack.
Just so you're taking notes. The second thing that's taken points off is, wow,
a bench like this, you really think they'd take better care of it. You know, like, you got rust, you got paint peeling off, and it's the kind of thing that when I see that, I immediately know two things. I immediately know, one, this is a bench that isn't cared about, really, by the community surrounding it, and two, it was a waste of time to drive out here, you know, because this wasn't what I was told I was going to be getting into. I was told I'd be getting a 10 out of 10 bench. But it's not all bad. It's not all bad. There's some cool things about it too. If you take a look down here, you have this sort of cast metal clover design, very reminiscent of some of the Art Deco benches I saw on my tour in Ireland, when I went on kind of a, I called it a bench packing tour because I was backpacking and I looked at benches and stuff like that. I toured all around Europe. Spoiler alert, that's one of the reasons I was not uploading for a little bit. I was on vacation. So we have this cool clover design, reminiscent of some of that European kind of style bench design. Here we see a gorgeous where the clovers pointing outward, shaped like hearts, symbolize love to the external, love to the outside world, love to what's outside our physical reality, love for God. As you can see, surrounding crescent moon shapes or hearts, further symbolizing this spiritual connection between the divine and the bench. This is something that we see mirrored in Victorian, Greco-Roman, Byzantine, Turkish architecture, and it's something that
Egyptian,
thank you, architecture, and it calls one, it reminds one of death and the finality of life. Let us not forget that a bench is a place to be stationary, a place to be close to the ground, a place to be one with the earth, with the stars. You see the same insignia echoed on the very other side.
I don't know about any of that. I just think it looks cool.
I think that's really nice. I think it's really cool. I think it's a good detail. I wish they took better care of this bench. Feels solid. It feels sturdy. It's, you guys know me, it's almost reminiscent of like the yogurt covered pretzel benches. Not quite. Cause it's the same sort of material on the outside.
It's like ice cream sandwich. Like with the holes. Like an ice cream sandwich.
Yeah, but it's green. Okay, anyway, thank you. Anyway, so it's the same sort of material. It's a little shinier, which makes me think it might be newer. It might be more of like a, less of a matte finish. And I kind of like that. I like my benches to stand out. I don't like dull, gray, boring, disgusting, loser type, you know, trash. I don't like trash is what I'm saying. And, yeah, without further ado, let's give this guy a sit. All right, let's get her going. Can you tell I'm nervous right now? I haven't been on a swing or anything like a swing in, gosh, years and years and years. Okay. All right. Whew. This is why I scope out the locations first. Just so we're remembering. Okay. So this is, yeah,
All right, I'm gonna open my eyes. Okay. Yes, okay. I'm here. Centered. Grounded. It's first impressions. It's very comfortable. It has a nice curve to it. I'm trying really hard, not because I'm very animated when I... Sorry. I'm very animated when I talk, so I'm trying really hard to keep my motions really low and tight and not super animated right now, because I'm really trying hard not to shake this thing, because I'm starting to see now that this is, it's not even a gimmick, it's a safety hazard, this kind of chain design. I can...
You kids these days, you're saying everything's offensive, everything's dangerous, everything's a hazard to your health. Well, I fought in World War II, and I tell you what, the benches we had there were 10 times more dangerous than this. Did we complain? We didn't complain, because we were tough back then, not like little weaklings.
You old timers, you are always saying that we need to be tougher and stronger and stuff like that, but we're the ones that are making progress. You know, we're the ones that are making new innovative benches like this one that have features like the swings and the chains. We're the ones that make benches better. I'm gonna post this on my TikTok. Whoa!
Oh my God, you guys. This is the argument that's in the comment section every single dang day, and I'm getting sick of it. Old versus new. First of all, this bench, not that innovative. Sorry, the only new thing it does, really, is the chains. And as I've already said, that's bad. That's not actually making the bench any better. It's making the bench worse. It's making it dangerous, it's making it a hazard. Second of all, old timer. Are you seriously suggesting that making benches safer is a bad thing? Is that really what you're saying? Really? Really? Seriously. Like, listen to yourself. That's so idiotic.
Boomer.
Thank you. Thank you. That's so idiotic. Making benches safer makes them better. Because if you think about it, humans have had benches for hundreds of thousands of years. Hundreds of thousands of years. And the true innovation hasn't come, this is going to be controversial, it hasn't come in their design or their materials. It hasn't come in any of that. It's come in their safety. It's come in their safety. Look at a car, right? Cars have stayed pretty much the same for the last 200 years. But look at a bench. If you look at a bench from 10,000 years ago and a bench from today, what's the biggest difference is their safety. That's really why I don't sit on old benches, why I seek out the new and the exciting, is safety is what makes it better. That is the most idiotic thing I've ever heard. That is the most idiotic thing I've ever heard. Benches have been improving in more ways than just safety. That's insane to say that benches have been staying the same other than their safety for 10,000 years. That's ridiculous. That's idiotic. That's stupid. This guy again? Seriously? That's not what I was saying. What I was saying to the old timer was benches becoming safer isn't a bad thing. It's not making people weaker. It's making benches better.
Nobody makes these arguments.
Nobody thinks this bench is a 10 out of 10.
So, nobody wanted to come out here today. Nobody wanted to drive out here. So, the weather and everything This is my show. We don't talk.
Yeah, this is his show.
We don't talk.
Back off.
Thank you. But I can speak for myself.
But like, I'm here to be like your support, you know?
This is my show, I don't need.
Well, like, I don't know.
I can do it with a tripod. So can we just keep filming? Because I can go to Best Buy and I can buy a tripod. If you drive me to Best Buy, I'll go buy a tripod. And that's all it takes. So,
I'm not gonna drive you to Best Buy though. What if I just leave you here?
You wouldn't do that.
One thing that I really do enjoy about this bench is the smoothness, the texture. One thing that you see on these kind of like, I like to call them the yogurt-covered pretzel
benches. Squid Game! I love Squid Game! Everybody should watch Squid Game!
Get out! We don't need you! We don't need you! Get out! Get out of here!
Do you want me over here for just a second?
Ned, I think you're missing some of the key features of this bench. You haven't mentioned the arch at all. And there's tons of other things you haven't even considered yet, so what gives?
Jack, can I borrow your hat for a second?
Sure.
Thank you.
I think you're missing the key features of this bench. You're missing some of its strengths. You haven't even mentioned the arch yet. I think you're missing some of the key strengths of this bench. Look at the arch. Oh, the arch. Look at the arch. You're missing the key features. Look at the arch of this bench.
All right, guys, I think we've all seen what we need to see. I think we've all been here for long enough. We all want to be getting done with this episode. So, what do I think of this bench? Well, I have made it no secret this whole episode that I do not think it was worth it to come out here. I don't think it was fun. It was not a good film. It was not a good shoot. It was not a fun working environment. It was very hostile. I was getting hostility from everywhere. But I still think
half of your own hostility is made up though. Not to say that that's not,
but they're representations of the comments. So I'm still getting the hostility.
Okay. I'm sorry, Ned. Are you mad at me, Ned?
We can talk about this in a second. Cause I need to.
Okay. But like, are you mad at me?
Tripods are $15 and they don't interrupt my reviews.
Sorry.
Yeah. So anyway. I think I'm about ready to give this bench a score. Very comfy, very smooth, very pretty. I love the designs on the side. I like the chains, you know, super cool, fun feature. Really adds a lot of excitement to the bench. Overall, this bench, was it worth it to come all the way out here? No, it was not. But I'm still going to give this bench a 9 out of 10. All right, everybody. That was another episode of Epic Bench Critic Reviews. I hope you enjoyed this episode. I know you guys have been waiting for a long time for a new one. Like I said, that's not my fault. That's not coming from my side. That's coming from all around me. So,
I dropped it.
I don't want to be out here. I don't want to be. Just finish the intro. Just finish it. What is going on with you today?
Just finish it. Jeez.
I know you guys have been waiting for a really long time for a new episode. Like I said, that's not coming from me. I have to send that out to my editor, get this edited. We're going to get this out for you just as soon as we can. We got some new stuff coming down the works. We got some big episodes planned. I know you guys are excited. I'm excited. I'm excited to get the heck home because I'm cold. It's so windy today. I want to give a quick shout out to the person in the comments who keeps recommending me benches in my area. I don't take recommendations from fans. I don't think it's right. I don't think it's ethical. But I just wanted to give you a quick shout out. I want to say you don't have to keep doing that because we have all the episodes planned that we need. We know all the benches in the area. So you're just taking your own time, and it's not helping us. But I do want to still say thank you. Thank you for being a supporter. Thank you for being a fan. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next review. Peace.
All right, that's another episode in the books.
Another good one, guys.
Yeah,
another good one.
Thanks for having us, Jack. I know Ned wasn't exactly.
It's time.
Wait, you again? Why are you back here? What do you need?
Noah Wentz has returned. The bench goblin's back. He's been destroying benches, duplicating unworthy benches. We need you, Ned. You need me. I'm you.
Well, why do you need me?
Because you're the Neddest Ned there is. Ned Prime. And the main Ned timeline. We need you.
But I can't help you. I have 2 more bench reviews to film today.
That may be true, but here's the thing.
I don't really care.
I'm gonna transport you now.
Just one thing to keep in mind, Ned. You're gonna have to duck.
Wait, what? Wait, no! Where am I?
This isn't right. This bench was destroyed. Something's really wrong here. I can feel the disturbances. Too much, even for me, and I'm ripped.
Wait a second,
isn't this?
They just wouldn't listen. God dang it!
My God. This is where it all started. Where it all began.
Yeah. 2 out of 10. I knew it wouldn't survive. Old reliable. Still a 7.5. How you doing, old girl?
No! 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 No!
I'm coming, Ned. Don't worry.
Need a mask in.
Who the hell are you?
My name's Corey and DeJayas. Now take this and I'll explain why. See, after this whole bit of a bench apocalypse started, we got all the benches vanishing, and now the rust content in the air is way higher than it used to be. So now you see him wandering around, unable to sit down. We call them standers. You don't want to become one of them.
Yeah, they're flesh. It's necrotic.
Necrotic is a light way of putting it, but yeah.
Well, thank you. I've been trying to look for my friend for the last 3 years.
Your friend?
Yeah. You know him?
Well, you didn't tell me his name.
Well, he's a bit of a bench legend.
Bench legend?
But he's been missing for 3 years. He had 23 subscribers on YouTube.
23? I can't say I'm much of a YouTube guy myself, but I do know that bench legends are a bit rare to come by around these times. Last one I heard of was...
Ned Clark?
No. His legacy. I did hear about Ned Clark, though. Is that your friend?
Yes.
Well, blimey! What are the chances? You see, I actually heard a little about from the, I'm saying, the last bench legend. His name was a fella named Jackson, yeah. Heard a little bit about him. Heard he learned from a man named Ned Clark, but nothing more than that, I'm afraid.
Well, I've been looking for Ned for years with no evidence.
Really? Well, if there's anyone who does know where a bench legend would be, it'd be... Noah Wentz and his wenchmen. They rule round here. Be careful. They normally patrol to keep the standards under control, but you don't want to get on their bad side.
I know about them. See, Noah used to be friends with my friend back in high school. No, middle school. But they had a bit of a falling out after Ned. Well,
I suppose if it's too hard to say, you don't need to say it.
No, it's okay.
Alright.
Noah was against benches. He would destroy every bench he saw. Violate them.
That's... I'd say that's impossible, but that's actually pretty accurate as to what's been going on around here. Rumor has it he's the one who started this entire bench apocalypse.
I'm not surprised.
His wenchmen patrol and make sure the standards don't get too out of control. But otherwise, you best be on your guard for them. I'd say you're lucky for not having run into any of them for 3 years.
I have, but I try to keep a low profile. I don't think we should be talking about this at all, in fact.
Fair enough. But let me tell you this.
Yeah.
You seem like a well-to-do gal. You seem a little troubled, though. Little in need of assistance. How about this? I've been looking for a bit of a bench legend myself for my own reasons, but I'll help you out. I'll find you Ned Clark for you.
Deal. Coriander Jayas, are you ready?
Absolutely, Miss Red Phoenix.
Delta Corsair, are you ready?
Yes. Actually, it's a bit hard.
Remember, the one goal is to extract the target.
Are the rumors about this guy true?
Yeah, like, how do we know he's even gonna be on our side?
let's just say, I knew him once.
So, what's going on, boss?
There are intruders in the facility.
What are we gonna do?
Take them out.
I've been expecting you. You're late.
Well, these bloody wenchmen aren't making it easy, that's for damn sure.
Hey, at least we got you at all. Anyway, let's get out of here.
It's go time.
Reviews, hiding, lurking in the background when nobody could see me. I've been collecting information on Ned for years, and it's time that this finally paid off.
Hold on, guys. I got this.
Don't worry, Ned. I got this. Ned, save me!
It's over.
Hey, Bozo. Take a seat.
Let's find out who this goblin really is.
You don't know what you're doing. You don't know what you've started.
My God. How is this possible?
Ned! It's me! It's you!
This can't be, I closed that time loop.
Wait a sec.
Coriander!
Is that Jack?
I heard about them once. Coriander! Coriander!
Help me!
Jack! Listen to me! You're still in there somewhere!
You're still in there!
What are we gonna do? Ned is in danger.
Guys, I'm racking my brain here. I don't know what we should do. I just don't know.
All we need to save Ned is some good old-fashioned true grit spirit.
Squid Game! Squid Game! I love Squid Game!
Get out!
We don't need you!
Perhaps we should come up with some sort of
strategy to save him, to combine our powers.
I don't want to, but the guy needs help.
Sorry, buddy. You weren't ever half the bench critic I was. Phoenix! Phoenix!
Seen that shit in years.
It wasn't popular since the 70s. Yeah, they phased these babies out. Well built though. 8 out of 10. What happened back there? Where's Corian?
He ran off. I think he's gone somewhere over here. I was trying to follow him, but I lost his scent a while ago.
It's not like Corian. He isn't half the soldier I am, but he can hold his own. It's not like him to run away like that.
Yeah, Coriander was the best soldier in training, but I guess he wasn't reliable after all.
Looking for someone?
Coriander, what happened back there? You abandoned us! You abandoned me!
There's no way I... Look, there are some reasons for what I had to do. Now, you may know me by another name. I am known as the one, the only, the devious king of mischief. Noah Wentz.
Noah, somehow I knew you were behind all this. Well, I'm not gonna let this go on any longer. I've let you live for far too long. And I've let you take the lives of far too many innocent benches.
Wait. Before we truly settle our differences, bench critic, I've got one question for you. Have you ever wondered why your pal, Dark Phoenix, fights so valiantly for your sake? Haven't you ever wondered why she fights for you? Why she broke into such an elaborate facility in prison, all for your sake? Have you ever really wondered, Ned, who really was behind that mask?
Phoenix, who are you?
It's me, Ned. It's Meg.
All this time, you were fighting for me. And I didn't even pay you back with that date you always wanted. Well, I'm not gonna let that happen anymore.
Action. Kiss me,
Megan.
Do I have to, Megan?
Yeah, it's for the.
I love you too, Megan. I've always loved you, just not as much as benches. But I did love you.
You see, I was a bench critic just like you.
Impossible!
On the contrary, I loved benches. Nothing felt quite as nice as the loving caress of a bench. As you very well know, I even made a bench of my own once. But one fateful day, I got a splinter. Never had I experienced so much rage before. I hated what that bench had did to me. So I found a way to channel my hatred. And it felt good. I then began destroying the very benches I swore to protect and love. I carved my name
on every bench. And now, I've destroyed so many benches throughout this benchpocalypse that you feel it necessary to duel me. Well, I say, bring it on.
I see.
You were my brother! You betrayed me!
So you say, Ned.
But who is it really
who betrayed you?
You betrayed benches!
No. I came before benches. I came
when chairs were a thing.
Impossible!
I witnessed
the change from chairs to benches as Americans got fatter and fatter.
A mere chair to them was a stool to others. A mere bench to them became a chair.
That is the true reason behind the benches of today.
You know nothing!
I know everything! Everything!
Do you know this?
What?
Goblin!
What is it?
You know me!
Do I?
I
know you!
I have long arms!
What?
It's over. Back to my dimension.
doesn't swear.
He doesn't.
Doing whatever a bench critic does.
Yeah.
Go.
Oh, fuck my phone. Wait, where do we stop again?
Right here.
That's
right
perfect.
There
with the stick. Okay, sweet. Can we back up again so I know where to stop? Well, these bloody winks. Fuck.
It was good, though.
You know, and that's why, viewers, benches like these.
Can you, like, see my happy face?
Action.
Wait. Ready?
Action.
Coriander, what happened to you? You abandoned us. You abandoned me. Look, it wasn't my fault. Oh shit, I brought the British accent. Back up.
Zone action.
What's
that? Wiener.
No, wait, this is too bad. This is bad.
Is today the day, Mother? Is today the day the prophecy spoke of?
I don't like this at all. Can we redo this?
I remember this spot. 9 out of 10 bench. Huh. One of the worst shoots of my life. Negativity from all sides. Probably what started the bench apocalypse.
Fuck.
Yeah, that's fine.
Oh shit, it's not. Oh shit.
This is fucking difficult.
Oh shit, it started recording. Fuck, no. Shit.
We call them standards. Now put that on. You don't want to turn into one of them.
Are you sure this isn't just something Joe Biden